The Real Truth About Teens and Sex by Sabrina Weil, excerpt from Chapter 1 Truth. Life That You'd Never Tell Your Parents. 1 in 11 14-year-olds say yes. 0.1 in 8 15-year-olds say yes. 0.1 in 5 16-year-olds say yes. 0.1 in 3 17-year-olds say yes. We lie to you because we don't want to disappoint you. Or get yelled at. Bethany, 17, New Jersey. Many parents have confessed to me that, at some point, they have experienced a nearly irrepressible urge to rifle through their teen's backpack. Or to read their teen's journal, be it an online diary or a lined book filled with loopy script that was left spread eagle and spine up near the family computer. Practically emblazoned with "Read me, she'll never notice," it's understandable that parents would want to do a little investigating. Even without any solid evidence or direct testimony, there are clues when a teen is embarking on a journey for which his or her parents did not plan the itinerary. The left on-screen "I am" to a girl with an unfamiliar name that ends "I love you," or a thong underwear in the wash that was not a parent-endorsed purchase. Even though we know teens have a social life that frequently doesn't include adult supervision, the oft-sudden realization that they may be hiding such an important part of their lives can be a startling wake-up call. Just as a teenager's life gets more complicated, the stakes get higher. Heartbreak, STDs, and pregnancy become immediate risks. At the same time, from a developmental standpoint, teens are supposed to be pulling away from the adults in their lives. In a sense, this pulling away is good for both parents and teens. It's one thing to be an 11-year-old's main confidant, but no parent truly wants a play-by-play of their 15-year-old's date, any more than a teen wants to know the details of his or her parents' romantic life. But at the same time, many teens do not have the maturity, judgment, or sophistication to make possibly life-changing decisions regarding sex without the input of an older, wiser adult. So, that's the bind we find ourselves in, needing to 1. See what's truly going on in teens' sex lives and 2. Talk to teens about sex and sexuality in a way that will empower them to confidently make intelligent, responsible decisions, even though they act like they don't want to talk to us at all, let alone about sex. On the front lines of this communication gap, many parents and other adults who care about teens have pulled me aside to ask, "What's going on with my teenager? I found this thong underwear, love letter, condom, and I'm not sure what it means. Is my teen in love? Or in danger? Or both? Help, and I think I can help because teens confide in me." Ever since I began communicating with teens more than a decade ago as the sex and body columnist for 17 magazine, teens have been telling me what they consider to be their deepest, darkest secrets, secrets they are too afraid or too embarrassed to reveal to their parents, their teachers, or the adult in their lives they feel closest to. Often, these are secrets teens think adults can't handle. "What would happen," I sometimes ask, "if you told your parents what's really going on with you? They'd freak out, they'd kick me out of the house, they wouldn't understand, they don't know what it's like to be a teenager now." Even though I generally like to take a listen without judging approach to teens, this is the one place where teens so often get it wrong. Most of the parents I speak to want to know more about what's going on with their teen's life, not to persecute them or put them on lockdown, but to help them. Teens want to close the communication gap. As I was starting research for this book, one sent an email to teens saying, "Listen, I know it can be hard to talk about sex, so if you tell me your secret thoughts, feelings, and actions, I'll share your words in the book to help adults understand where you're coming from and how best to help you." You might think teens would say, "No thanks. I'll keep my most intimate thoughts to myself if it's all the same to you." It is, after all, the rare teen, dare I say, no teen, who wants to break the news about what they're up to sexually to their own parents. This is, in part, because of the embarrassment factor. And anecdotal as well as scientific research and good common sense tells us that teens, like children of all ages, are loath to disappoint their parents. 0.53% of 12 to 17-year-olds are very or extremely concerned about disappointing their parents. Another 36% report they are concerned, 8% are a little concerned, only 3% are not concerned at all, but they did confide in me. Hundreds of teens contacted me, eager to share the most intimate details about their love and sex lives, or lack thereof, and stating quite explicitly that they wanted me to tell parents and other adults in their lives about their secret thoughts, their personal feelings, and even their most private actions. "I have to say, your book is a wonderful idea," said Melinda, 16, from Washington. Many parents these days think they know what's going on with their kids. So kudos to you for educating the parents on what's going on. So many teens express this sentiment to me in one way or another that it reinforces my belief that despite the horrified looks on their faces when we bring it up, teens want to discuss sex and sexuality with an adult they trust. They want parents to know what's going on. They just don't want to be the ones to bring it up. What's really going on? You don't have to look too hard in your local paper, on the news, or yes, even in my email inbox, to find panic-inducing stories about teens having group sex at parties or on buses or playing sex games and getting pregnant at tender ages. These rumors and trends are addressed in the next chapter. In this chapter, I want to provide the big picture, today's teen sex landscape, what's going on with most teenagers across the country. These statistics and revelations are based on my interviews and contact with teenagers, as well as national surveys, including my nationwide Teens Tell the Truth survey of more than 1,000 teenagers, which I've produced in consultation with the National Campaign to Prevent Teen Pregnancy, the results of which are revealed in this book for the first time. Knowing the truth about teens and sex is the first step to helping teenagers sift through the ever-changing choices and vital decisions they will make in the coming years. And, happily for both parents and teens,